Hello, Dupros, and welcome back to my IT workshop. This is your boy, Alvin Drill. As you can see, I'm in front of a Windows 10 computer. I'm showing you that this computer is working with no problems. Everything is functional. So in this video, I'm going to show you what happens when you remove the CMOS battery on a computer that is working, that is turned on. So the computer we're going to use for that is this HP ProDesk 600 G1. I have done some videos in the past using this model, like upgrading the BIOS version or turning this old computer into a budget gaming machine. So if you're interested in that, I'm going to leave the links for those videos in the video description below. So this is the CMOS battery. We're going to remove it. And this computer, of course, this case is connected to the monitor over here. I'm showing you that I'm not wearing any jewelry or watches, and I'm going to discharge myself of any static electricity that I might have in my body by touching the metallic case for a few seconds. That way I don't damage the circuitry. So now with my plain head screwdriver, I'm going to remove it. By the way, this is for entertainment purposes or educational, so don't try to do this at home, all right? Or on your computer. So I'm going to remove it now. Pretty simple, it came out easily. So this is the classic 3-volt CMOS battery. So allow me a few seconds to go back to the monitor. So as you can see, the computer is still functional. Nothing has happened. Everything is working. So this is the CMOS battery in more detail. This is how it looks. And now, since nothing happened, I'm going to reboot the computer to see if something comes up. As you can see, the computer is rebooting now. And while it's doing that, this is a good time for you to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet. That really, really helps my channel a lot. So thank you very much. So this reboot took like 45 seconds or so. That was kind of long. After that, I was able to see the login screen for Windows, so nothing really happened. So now I'm going to shut it down, not just reboot, just shut it down. So now I'm going to show you the computer now that it's totally shut down. So I'm spinning with my hands the fan for the processor, so it's really dead. Now, I'm going to turn it on one more time to see if something has changed, but nothing, okay? I can still see the Windows login screen. So now I'm going to shut it down, and now I'm going to disconnect it from the power. So you can see the power supply there, so I'm disconnecting the cable, and now I'm going to press the power button for around 10 seconds, 15 seconds to get rid of all the electricity storing the capacitors, as you can see there. So that way it's like new, or if the computer hasn't been turned on for a long time. So now I'm going to connect it one more time, as you can see there. Next, allow me a few seconds to adjust my camera. Now I'm going to turn it on. So after a few seconds, it's going to show me these two messages or errors. So the first one is the system time is invalid. This may be a result of a loss in battery power, which is true, the CMOS battery is out. Set the correct time and date using your operating system. If this message persists, you may need to change, well, the battery. And the second is the system options not set. Your system configuration has changed since your last boot. Addition of a hard drive, etc., or loss of power to the real-time clock has occurred. So you can press F1 to save the settings that we see now, and then you can continue, well, doing what you need to do. So as you can see, now we have an error. So it took like after the shutdown, we have to disconnect the computer from the power supply and get rid of the electricity storing the capacitors. So this is going to show you when the computer has run out or when the CMOS battery is dead, so you need to replace it. Now I'm going to press F1 to continue booting to Windows, and the computer restarted. Now I only see the first message that set the correct time and date using your operating system. Press escape key to the startup menu to go to the BIOS and change it there. So I'm going to press escape and then F1, but it was not working. So I decided to shut down the computer, and now I'm going to put back the CMOS battery. Or if you have an old one, you have to replace it by a new one. So the process is very simple. Now allow me a few seconds to adjust my camera. I'm going to turn it on, and we have the exact same error. Now I'm going to press escape to get access to the startup menu, as you can see me doing over here, but it wasn't working. So I press F1, and now Windows is loading, but we have to set the time and date on the BIOS. So now I reboot the computer and I'm pressing escape. Now I am in the startup menu. From here I go to computer setup, or F10, you press on that. It took a few seconds. And now we have this. So in the first tab, I'm going to go to set time and date. So you configure the time and date that you have. I recorded this some days ago. So after you do that, you have to save these settings and, you know, press F10 to save, then save changes and exit. Then it's going to ask you again if you want to save it. Yes. And now Windows is starting, as you can see over here. Now, if we reboot the computer, it's not going to ask us for that. It's not going to show us that error anymore because the time is set correctly in the BIOS, and in Windows you can set it up as well. So that's the short video about what happens when you remove the CMOS battery when the computer is on. So thank you everyone for watching. If you like this video, please leave a like and subscribe. If you have any other comment or questions, leave them in the comment section below. And as always, I'll see you in the next video.